Colombo is faced with a garbage conundrum in the wake of the Mitotomulo disaster. With protests erupting across the country, the question remains, where will Colombo's garbage go? Find out on News Matters. Colombo City is facing a garbage conundrum in the wake of the Mitotomulo disaster. With Mitotomulo no longer open to waste, the government is forced to look elsewhere. But sporadic protests have stood in the way. In Karadiyana Piliandala, where the government hoped to take Colombo's waste, residents converged to make their protest. They obstructed the path of the garbage disposal trucks and secured the facility against them. In Dompe, another site identified by the government as an alternate dumping ground, protests broke out when residents refused to allow garbage trucks deposit their load. In Attidiya Dehivala, in Kotikavatta, in Veyangoda, the protests were repeated. The citizens' cry was the same, don't let another Mitotomulo develop here. Citizens are afraid a dump site as large as the 300-foot Mitotomulo mound will take shape in their locality, threatening their lives and putting their health at risk. Approximately 700 metric tons of garbage is collected daily from Colombo. What will the government do with this? Where will Colombo's garbage go? Disaster Management Minister Anur Priyadarshan Ayyappa is adamant the government will not change its stance. Garbage will be dumped in the areas identified, protests notwithstanding. But the standoff between authorities and residents continue. Citizens have to understand that the government cannot implement a sustainable and comprehensive waste disposal and recycling mechanism in a few days. The process will take time. Until the formulation of such a mechanism, the government will have to dump garbage at temporary sites in areas that are not too densely populated. But the government too has to understand that the patience of residents is wearing thin, especially in light of the Mitotomulo incident. Authorities can't take a lifetime to implement a sustainable garbage disposal system. An acceptable time frame should be adopted and the project should be completed within that time frame, and this should be communicated to citizens. In the absence of a sensible approach of that nature, the issue of garbage will be long-standing and never-ending standoff between the people and the government. In the interim, as citizens, we too can contribute to the solution without being a part of the problem. Environmentalists and environmental groups have repeatedly urged Sri Lankans to refrain from using polythene and plastics and to resort to other alternatives. If the use of polythene and plastic can be reduced, the volume of garbage generated in and around Colombo will decrease dramatically. We must not always look to the government for solutions to community problems. We too must play our part at a far greater degree. What requires emphasis is this fact that none of us, not the government, not the citizens, nor yet environmental bodies and agencies, are in any position to wash our hands off the issue. Garbage is a collective problem and must be dealt with collectively. The government must play its part, the citizenry must play its part, and environmental authorities must continue to sound the alarm over environmental issues. Join us for another segment of News Matters on Tuesday. I am Royal Raymond.
Get the Daily News app free on your mobile phone. Visit apps.lakehouse.lk and download today. Daily News. Be better informed.